And we now move on to our second panel discussion for the evening. The topic is creating out-of-home formats across regional markets that attract brands and engage consumers. And our moderator for the panel is Mr. Sanjay Tripathy, founder and CEO, Agilio. So we'll be taking a moment to set up the stage. Stanford GSB alumnus, recognized business leader with demonstrated leadership and renowned marketing, analytics, and digital expert with 26 years of industry experience in diverse domains and industries like FMCG, telecom, and BFSI. After hugely successful stints in organizations like GCMMF, PepsiCo, Mattel, Reliance, Infocom, and HDFC Life, Sanjay recently shifted gears and moved to the entrepreneurial space with Agilio. Please put your hands together to welcome Mr. Tripathy on stage. I also request Mr. Tripathy to please welcome the other panelists who should be joining us. Over to you, sir. Should I take the name of the panelists also?
Yeah. Yeah. Hi. I'll not spend too much time in introducing the panelists. Let me call on stage Dipankar Sanyal, CEO Platinum Communication. Neel Pandya, Head of Media L'Oreal. Nishith, Bhandarkar, President and CEO Eggfirst Advertising. By the way, he's got the best possible card I've seen ever. So please ask for his card. Next on stage, I would like to invite Sunit, Jain, CEO Outreach Advertising. Our last panelist today is Surabhi, Kulshreshtha, MD, Unicorp Solutions Private Limited, and Firstlook OH. Okay. So let me start the question with Dipankar. Dipankar, out of home media is really growing year on year, and you know the growth rate is around 6 to 7% as per different reports, and the market size is anything between 3,000 crore to 3,500 crores as per again different reports. Whether you follow Pitch, obviously you from addition you will be following Pitch, but so as per FICCI report, it says that next 5 years the industry will probably grow at a 11.8% cumulative growth. So can you, for the audience sake, can you explain what is regional markets we are talking about and what is non-regional market for this context?
Okay. To my mind, the regional markets, what we're talking about is basically the tier 2, tier 3 cities that we're talking about, or even lower down in the pop strata. What we're actually talking about is the metros and the state capital. We are moving beyond that. That is the market that we're actually talking about. So that's okay. The definition of the regional markets.
Okay. Nishith, can you just tell us, like, you know, what will be the size of that market? Like, you know, if we are talking about 3,000 to 3,500 crore is the overall OH market. So what will be the size of regional market which is beyond metros and, you know, state capitals?
I think there is immense opportunity what Dipankar was talking about. These are the only not the market. Other than there is a growing and emerging markets are also there in India. We have actually, the OH has not reached to very small towns, even tier 3 and tier 4 towns, which is emerging now. And specifically when we talk about the smart cities, though they are also constitute a large number of your regional flavor, they are also growing. So I don't have the exact number, what is the potential of this market, but this is really expanding and there's a lot of opportunity. Over the course of discussion, we'll go through and we'll unveil those opportunities which is coming forward.
Okay. Sunit, any idea, like, you know, how big is that market size that we are talking about?
To my understanding, you know, markets have been traditionally divided amongst metros and regions.
Okay.
So, you know, northern market, eastern market, southern market.
Okay.
And if I, you know, if you give me a minute, I would like to give my understanding of a regional market. Regions are, you know, every region, every market is actually a regional market. Even a metro is a region market because regions are made up of cultures and communities. And even if metro is a large market, if we are looking at regional market as an understanding of smaller market, so they form different forms of regional market. But in terms of advertising space, coming to your questions, what I get to understand is more than 50% is being today spent on large markets, and the remaining 40 to 50% is being spent on smaller markets, which can be termed as regional markets.
Okay. Come to Surabhi, you are like operating out of Bhopal market, and you know, so what you have you seen the what have you seen as a trend? Is the market spend of the marketeers, or the spend of the spend has grown in your market in the sense, like, you know, in the last 3 year trend, what you have seen, like, you know, whether you have more marketeers have come, like, you know, more on number of marketeers, more in terms of spend. So what is your experience?
Like, we have come up in the regional market from the last 1.5 years.
Okay.
What we have seen that if you give quality and if you give them services like the way they want, we get like higher market spends for rather, if you compare Indore to Bhopal, we are getting higher spend in Bhopal compared to Indore. So this is what services you offer and the way you offer and the quality you offer. I think the regional markets are picking up very fast and they are going to like rule the roost because most of the brands are going towards the regional markets.
Okay. So then that brings me to the brand marketeer in the group, the Neel. So Neel, you are heading media and you are there in Vodafone before, you know, you can tell from your experience across category in the sense, do you think marketeers are spending more in regional media, regional markets currently, or do you think there is any significant changes which has happened in last couple of years? Like Surabhi has said, like, you know, if you provide very, very good quality, that, like, you know, spend is really going to increase. Do you think that change happening?
Before going on to the spend, what you picked up, I think firstly I would want to say that all of us should give justice to Autofo. I think from a client angle, print TV se paisa bach gaya to Autofo mein dal dete. I think we should go away from that and we should definitely plan for Autofo. To quote an example, when my agency for Autofo, when I joined L'Oreal some 8 months back, I called them for a brief for annual media strategy. Most of them in the room were shocked and surprised. They're like, out-of-home ka bhi annual media strategy hota hai? I said, yes, we need to plan for out-of-home. So we need to budget out-of-home from the day one. We do not need to move away out-of-home. And coming to your point on talking about spends in regional market, I would suggest that if you are lying on the other side where you're saying that budgets are limited, I would suggest that regional markets, out-of-home in regional markets will do a tremendous job in terms of spreading the awareness. It's cost efficient. I think outside digital, OH is the only medium which is cost efficient. Print is really expensive. Television, regional channels, we all know how it is expensive. So it plays an efficient role there. And I think marketeers which I have worked with and which I have heard in the industry have started becoming smart and they have started moving on to a market disruption kind of activity. And this market disruption kind of activity are afforded only into regional marketing. I cannot paste Mumbai or Delhi into the entire city. In case I have budget, I can do it. But I think on a long run, if you choose wisely in regional market in investments, I have seen mind measures and sales both moving on through out-of-home itself.
You are the right client for the right audience, like, you know.
I come from agency, so I definitely.
I think all agency will want you on board in terms of, like, you know, going and talking to their clients. So coming back to Dipankar, what Neel said, does it make sense, like, you know, have you seen that as you are an agency partner, when you go to the clients, do you really suggest in that manner? Because in the outside discussion, what I heard most of the media owners say is that, you know, the agency is plays the spoil sport. They don't really position us well in terms of, they say no measurement, nothing, and, you know, like, you know, don't really spend money there. So do you believe it is true?
Not really. Very frankly, I'll say that there are two parts to this question. In fact, one, the best part is every category today is looking inside, okay? Be it FMCG, be it telecom, be it whatever, you talk about it and they're going beyond this, beyond the known markets. So that's the best part. So there is money, one. So there's no way that an agency would go and say, don't spend money there. So agency will definitely be part of it. Yeah, the challenges are real. Challenges are, most of the time we compare, I would say a metro kind of situation to those markets wherein the problem starts coming in. Yeah, because the formats, the way the media owners operate, that's very different. The aesthetics of the sites are very different. That's where the challenge is, and that's why we, as an agency, we try to be more cautious, because at the end of the day, we are looking after that brand. So we would not like that brand to be affected going into that market and getting affected. So we are very picky about the market that we're going into and how that should be represented.
So Nishith, Dipankar has mentioned a couple of challenges in terms of formats, in terms of they're more cautious. So what are the other set of challenges you face in when you're actually taking an original market, when you're trying to do a planning for the regional market?
I think most of our clients, what they feel, Neel has mentioned, is it's never been a part of the main plan of the media. They've been saying it's just a 22nd of the media, why should we spend? So even if the money is left, then probably they would. But we strongly believe, and as a creative plus media agency, we always strive to make a balance between what kind of communication should go. And obviously, we are looking at, and we have been in talk with a lot of government authorities to create a PPP model, where we don't have to actually bid for it, but get a property owner and take care of the long term. So it's not going to be advertising, but definitely is going to be more or CSR or maybe a long-term investment in terms of that. So the challenge is always in the terms of not the size, not the location, but it's all about the way the client and the brand behave towards the OH. That's the what we feel about.
Okay, the brand marketer is saying that he looks at regional market positively, but agency guy is thinking that there are a lot of challenges. Sunit, can you just tell me, what you have seen from your experience, what are the real challenges in the regional market space? Is it Dipankar mentioned about, it is about the asset quality, Nishith mentioned about, it is about, understanding whether this is right, getting more detail, data about the site kind of thing. So what are the challenges you have faced?
I have two perspectives on this. One is from the asset point of view, there have been massive improvisation, I could say, over the last couple of years, 6 to 7 years particularly. Outreach advertising, the company that I represent, we particularly operate in the northeast region of India. And ever since we started operating in that market, there is a lot of kind of professional delivery systems that we have put in place, which was missing earlier, could be said. There were transparency issues, there were hygiene issues, what Neel and Nishith are mentioning more particularly. But we are now executing campaigns which are pan-India and with the same level of deliveries which has been expected from us. And I'm sure Dipankar would vouch for it, because we have worked on various campaigns together in the Northeast market. So one is that. So that is not a challenge. So that is a perception, the perception is the challenge. Second part is, I think there is the challenge is that of lack of insights also, Sanjay. I think a lot of brand marketers, brand managers, media agencies, agency representatives have also to go down deep in the market now, because most of them actually sit in the comfort zone. I'm just generalizing, I'm not saying anybody particular, in the comforts of their headquarters.
Neel is mentioning about you.
Yeah, so they sit in Delhi, Bombay, Bangalore headquarters, and they sit with the agency, and then the agency passes on to their regional offices. And there are a lot of opportunities in regional markets in terms of new formats that they can offer, which a metro market would struggle, basically because there are penetration issues, there are clutter issues, there are other challenges of a metro market or a large market, which is an opportunity for a regional market, which I see.
Sanjay, I would mention one of the challenge from my end, from a brand's angle. I think the biggest challenge which we feel from a brand angle is that we pick up a print creative and put it on outdoor. At the end of the day, we don't think of outdoor campaign when the first step of outdoor, when first step of the campaign is actually utilized. We don't shoot for outdoor. We shoot for digital campaign, we shoot for TV campaign, we shoot for key visuals into print, but we do not shoot for creatives made for outdoor.
So that you think, who is really responsible for that? Is the brand owner responsible for that? Is the creative agency is responsible for that? Or the media agency is responsible for that? Or outdoor owner is responsible for that? Because someone in the ecosystem would have told the brand guy, this is not going to work in outdoor. Why in the ecosystem nobody complains and it goes through all the way and people see a very bad creative, they don't even interested about out of home.
So, as all of us are responsible for the success, I think all of us are responsible for the downfall of creative.
But who's majorly responsible?
I'll tell you, if we start involving, so there is a concept which I work in my past previous company, which is called one team, one brief. If we start involving the out of home guys into the briefing of the campaign in its first stage, they are the one who will give you inputs while making the brand creative. I think if you start doing that as a step one, I think there are experts in this industry which are not utilized as of now. We need to involve them well in advance. And once that is covered and we know we're doing an out-of-home campaign, I think this solution is... We can't crib that brand name banaya isle ki visual achha nahi tha, ya fir agency ne name bolaya ki visual achha nahi tha. I think it's together we are responsible for it.
Okay, this is my question to the audience, all the out-of-home agency guys sitting here. How many of you really go back to the client saying that this is not a good creative, it's not really going to work? Sure? Okay. So my question to you is...
One point to make. See, this is what all about the perception when we say where the challenge. The perception, and secondly, when a media plan happens, you get the call if you want to do some activity in Northeast. There's a regional manager who says, no, this plan is not going to work. I know the vendor, I'll get you. So people think the way the scientifically television, radio or the print has been planned, it is not. My regional manager, area manager, even sales executive also plan it because they know the location very well. They know the traffic very well. You don't know, you guys sitting in Mumbai, Delhi and Calcutta, you don't know about the market. So probably this is the last priority for them. They don't really care about it.
No, I'll come to Surabhi. You are actually the asset owner over there. So all the challenges people talked about, one is like, you know, aesthetics, perception, insight, then, you know, creative. So how you actually, like, you know, you discuss outside, like, you know, even technology. So what are the things when 1.5 years back you decide, your company decided to come into this space, how you tackled that, you know, and how you got a number one perception in your market, let's say Bhopal market?
First of all, I would like to say that when we came into this field, we came up with very good media. That is like the first LED backlit that in outdoors. So when we go for we ask the person to come for Reiki for all the locations, and when they saw in actual, they need to come and
see. So you made all your site LED backlit?
Yes,
backlit?
All our sites are LED backlit in outdoor. So and
So you improved the asset quality. That's the first point.
First of all, we improved the asset quality. We
so
improved
what
the
else?
Structure of the. Of the media as such, it's okay. Not. It doesn't look rusted. It doesn't look tattered.
Okay.
It looks like a piece of the advertisement as such, so that they become the part of the brand. They
okay. Second, improve the structure. Next.
Yes. Yes. No. It doesn't. Because we have got the structural stability report for that, so that whenever the media owners come to us, we just tell them we you are going for the best media in town. So always we get most of the ad campaigns, whoever lands in Bhopal, whoever sees our media, they get to us and we book them. So this is easier for us too because we get to give them quality.
So what about measurement? Had you added anything on measurement to
yes,
get
we are
more
working
trust
out,
and percent,
we are working percent. Out. We are working out on that. We have come up with a plan which measures the actual traffic on road, where you can measure the number of vehicles on road. Then we can give you like a handle for which you can have. We are creating an app for that also. You can count the traffic on the road. We can count all the cars or the even bikes, even trucks with the sizes. So that will be like a real-time data which anybody
traffic
can access.
Count of the site.
Yes, anybody can access, and it also gives you data in packets, whichever you choose, like 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 1 day, or 1 month, so that you can choose your campaign time at that period. It will be easier for the campaigners to go ahead for that time or for those locations also.
Okay. So after you, like, you know, you change the perception having better quality assets in place. So, like, you know, you said people saw that, you know, then come to you.
Yeah.
But really, are you charging higher rate from the from the agency are still not giving you higher rate?
We are not charging any higher, but we are charging, you know, at par to the whatever is there. Whatever we are actually, you know, the market rates we are actually charging. We are not charging any much higher than that.
So you're not making, you're not making losses in that?
No.
Okay. So you're saying at the same rate asset quality can be improved, but
asset
nobody else
quality can be improved because there has been, I think, almost no investment on the media owners' part to change the perception of the media as such, which I think has become very shabby in regional markets.
But have you added other assets? Because most of the smaller markets are, like, you know, the markets we are talking about is mostly hoardings or bus shelters. Have you added other assets classes over there in Bhopal, or, like, you know, you're still operating in these two asset classes?
We are operating in this one also only, because we will be foraying into other assets very soon, like within 6 months, and there also we'll be having more better quality, like whatever we portray will be the best in industry.
Okay, so Dipankar, coming back to you, like, do you think asset classes, availability of better asset classes or digital OH will make a difference in the perception of client and measurability and other indices which you have talked about towards regional, like client's perception towards regional market? Because whenever we go, we say very bad quality, our memory is very bad quality, and memory of no other advertiser of my category. You know, I'll see some sari shop owner or a jewelry shop is advertising. I think, okay, this is not the market for me to really come back when I was in the client side, to come back and really advertise in there. Do you think asset classes, availability of asset classes will make a difference?
Definitely it's going to make a difference. See, the important thing is, as I said, client is ready to spend, but, you know, the times have changed. I mean, when you were there, and what the difference when ITC, if I recall the ITC, good old days of ITC tobacco spend, the client used to invest a lot of money in this medium. Today, the table has turned, and today the advertiser wants the media owner to spend and make a call out that, yes, I have this media. So probably what she is doing or the company is doing, that is something that advertiser is looking at. Yes, I have a ready-made media. Yes, I have created a world-class stuff. Come to me, and the advertiser is ready to spend. So I think, yes, that is going to make a lot of difference.
Neel, what do you think? What are the other asset classes has got potential in smaller town or regional markets? Like, as a brand marketer, which are the other asset classes you'd like to see? Because most of the places in a smaller town, we only see hoardings and the bus shelter. There's the only two things which are available. So with the smart cities coming in, you know, there are other things coming in. What do you think, what is really available in metro and top number one cities? If that gets available in the smaller towns, probably, like, marketers will change their views and, you know.
I think more or less outside the billboards and the bus shelters, which are doing justice in the regional market, I think in metros we have done good amount of investment into creating assets at railway stations and a lot of bus stops and other things. I think in regional market it becomes really important to create a 360 medium communication to the consumer, either while he's traveling into a train, and you can do announcements into train, which would be out of home plus XYZ announcement together. I think that's what is missing. I think digitization in regional market is also important from a perspective, because if you do a simple digital out of home kind of a campaign into a metro, no one is bothered to even look at it. But if you do the same thing into a regional market at a tier 2 and tier 3 at the same cost, I think you create a lot of eyeballs, you create a lot of talkability around it. I think that's where I think you need to invest more into assets, and we need to move out from billboards and shelters.
So how will you solve the electricity challenge in the smaller towns? Because once you do digital, that requires more electricity, that backlit things is doing, unless you have got a permanent contract or a separate deal with the electricity board, you will not get the electricity.
I don't think so. From Vodafone or a L'Oreal perspective or experience of mine, I've gone into those level of tier 3, tier 4 areas where electricity issues have been really not. But backlits have been really worked from a Vodafone perspective. I think out of home at the POS is really important from that particular. I don't think so. I'm the right guy to answer from the electricity issue. I think there are experts here who would definitely answer.
Okay, I'll come
thing.
To Sunit, like, you know, because you are operating in Northeast, which is really, really classical case where we get little of government support. So what are the other things, like, you know, for digital OH, I think, you know, government rules also need to change a lot in terms of making DOH available in this thing. So what are the things you think government should do differently to support this sector, at least in smaller towns?
See, I think
DWH is still a far cry nationally and metro markets as well. So regional markets, we can still talk about it in possibly the next session of this conference. but in terms of, you know, the other initiatives that the government has already taken and even the private players like us have initiated over the past couple of years in markets like Northeast is we have undertaken a lot of BOT projects, a lot of PPP projects with the government, wherein we have been setting up modern traffic signal systems. We have been setting up now footover bridges. So there are escalator footover bridges which are happening in Guwahati. So, I mean, that is again a matter of perception that, you know, people do not know or people tend to assume that, you know, markets like Northeast possibly or other smaller regional markets would have typical 2010s and hoardings and bus shelters only. But we have escalator footbridges, we have mall facades, we have airport, which is, you know, amongst the top 12 in the country today. We have almost all formats, I mean, unipoles and everything. Yeah, so.
No, that brings me to the next question. I think airport is a very good example. We have got 300 airports, and if you look at most of the airport creative, except like top 5 or 6 airport, if you go there, you know, the quality really drops drastically. The quality of assets are poor, the quality of advertising is poor, quality of clients available over there is poor, over there are poor. So again, if you look at traffic count has increased drastically, as you're saying, in Guwahati or like, you know, taken any small city, any time you go, the airport is completely full, both outside and inside. So why is not change happening in airport, which is a controlled medium, which is like, you know, you can improve the quality? Why the change is not happening in the airport space?
I think the airport scenario which we're talking about is now 2 years old. Now, if you look at the way the government and the department is taking care of all the refurbishing, all the airports are happening. There's a new bidding is also going to happen. There's going to be a premium is going to be charged from the bidder, and also, of course, it will impact on the advertisers as well. So I believe the things are changing. Even I have been traveling to the small towns, maybe cities, maybe in Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, and Orissa. Look at the airport is as equal as Mumbai and Delhi. So looking at their standard may not be a huge footfalls and traffics are going on, but things are really changing. So airport, I don't see the problem. The challenge is always the small town where the shabby nature of the property which is available, and there is no fixed rate card. So anybody can go, buy, pick up, and your media plan can be always questioned by the guy who doesn't know anything about the media planning.
Neel.
I think it's a demand and supply issue. I think a lot of client and people do not demand airport branding across the regional markets, and hence I think the government and the media asset owners are not investing much around it. I think the demand increases, the supply should improve, and I think assets should change around that.
I think Dipankar is the right stage, like, you know, you're a right size, like, you know, out of home agency to say. So how many clients really actually ask for a OH planning for regional market, or like, you know, how many you have to push? What is the percentage of clients?
Very difficult question. In fact, we are planning for this for all our, almost all our clients are going into this regional market. I mean, if I just give you an example of Idea being one of our clients, and in MPCG circle, they're in 210 towns, so it's one brand.
No, telecom is a category, it is there. You know, FMCG is a category, I understand. Yeah. But there are multiple categories which probably are not going. So when I segregate the market as per the categories, there are some categories which is definitely are prone to, like, you know, from a childhood we are seeing that those brands are there, like, you know, FMCG obviously has to be there. Yeah. So what are the new categories which can go but they have not really gone from your experience? That's what I was asking. Okay.
Difficult. E-commerce now? Not really. I mean, e-commerce is taking its own beating. So, automobile probably. Yeah, I think automobile could be one.
Okay.
Otherwise, most of the clients that we work with are going to.
Sunit.
I want to add to that. I think, you know, the sheer pause that Dipankar took to ask, respond to this justifies the question and the answer that not many clients are actually going to regional market to do regional specific campaigns. There are no clients. Trust me on this.
Yeah.
There are very, very few cases that, you know, industry members would hear, you know, actually cite examples that, you know, we did this. I would cite one for reference here. So this was around 2014. You know, there is a large FMCG major who has a personal care line. So we did a fantastic regional campaign for them with Rajiv Da being present here. We did a fantastic campaign with them in Assam. So that was a regional campaign for a national brand. So I think if Sanjay, you are looking at an answer like this, that, you know, there are pan-India campaigns, see, where, you know, regional markets are also part of the pan-India campaign. So, you know, if L'Oreal is doing a campaign and, you know, so there are, you know, 8 metros and 20 towns and 30 villages and all that. So that's a pan-India campaign. There's
right.
no regional
right,
campaign.
Right.
But then, like I said, regional markets are made up of region, which are made up of communities and culture.
Right.
So unless as brand managers, brand owners, media agencies, we understand the culture of that region, we cannot reach out and engage with those customers. And we need to understand that. And that's how, I mean, that's the insight through which we can create regional campaigns. And there's another example that I would give. In fact, last Pujo in Calcutta, Durga Puja is big in Calcutta and Bengal. So Pantaloons did this Alpana on the road. Yeah, and that was a campaign that the entire country was talking about. It went viral on the social, everybody was talking about. So there was a, you know, a great cultural context in which the campaign was built. Calcutta, although being a metro market, but there was a regional flavor to it. So that's, I think, the understanding of regional market and creating regional campaigns. That's what we need to look into. I strongly believe in that.
No, that's a very good point. I think, Nishith, you are giving that example of Samsung, like, you know, where they have to pull out the campaign because they have not. Can you just give that example to the audience, like, you know, so that, you know, what he said and
you
how...
You are putting me in jail. You are putting me in jail. Tomorrow, if I have to pitch, those guys will throw me out from the door. So... There's a Twitter trending. There's a campaign. Again, I will not name the brand. You have already spelled out. So the brand has did the campaign, All India, and is specifically talking about thank you for taking our business to XY crore, 1,000 crores, number one or something like that. And Western India contributes to maximum number of their revenue to their business. And it was found as nobody, and there was icons from each of the regions. If the Bengalis, so the Bengali man and women, if the South, so the South husband and wife, or so on and so forth. But when it comes to the Western India, there was no representation for a Maharashtra culture. There's no lady in Nawari sari which they wear, or the gentleman who is with the topi and whatever. So there was a tweet which is going on, I'm talking the last year, and say that we are the biggest contributor to your business, but you have not, my representation was not there. And that was a huge trending, and after that, they had to pull out from the newspaper, television, and every place.
I think that's something that we have learned long back, which is one size cannot fit all. And
yeah.
We have to look at regional markets in pockets.
No, I want him to say, my worry is when that reaches the billboard, that means it has gone through 4 levels. It has gone through client, it has gone through the creative agency, it has gone through the media agency, it has gone through the out-of-home owner. So why 4 of them, they didn't, like, you know, for a Samsung brand, I'm understanding they'll have all good agencies throughout, you know, including the brand team. So that's my bigger worry. I think somewhere, my perception or, like, you know, my like belief is that somewhere, you know, we just think, okay, creative has come, we have to execute. We don't put our mind or we don't raise our hand saying that, okay, something can be changed or something can be made different. Because if you are all intelligent people, if you have put our mind, I don't think that will ever reach the billboard level and, you know, people not noticing it. So, Neel, it brings me to my last question. And so what do you think can be done for the regional market to really take in the plan for the most of the brand market here, be it... Is it technology will make a difference? Is it like measurability will make a difference? It will really having the better quality signages will make a difference? Or it's a perception change from the client side will make a difference?
I think multiple things outside whatever you said. I think one thing which we as a brand have realized that you need to start treating regional creatives in regional languages. I mean, you don't put an English creative into a newspaper, in the newspaper. You don't put an English ad on a regional TV channel. In fact, there is a learning, enough case studies that regional creatives on digital are going best performance. I think we need to start picking up languages also into regional and being more relatable to the audience whom are we talking to. Secondly, I think I mentioned earlier also about is that market disruption activity we need to start focusing on. I think if you're limited budgets, be present for 3 months, change your creative after a month or so, and ensure a always-on kind of out-of-home approach from a media planning perspective, which definitely moves mind measures and even sales to that extent.
Surabhi, you want to add anything? No.
I would like to say that reliability is another big factor because most of the media owners from regional sectors are not reliable as such. including us, because I have, what I have observed, that they are not giving that kind of quality, and they are not giving that kind of, you know, reliability factor is a big factor, because most of the whatever campaigners think that, okay, I have put up this ad, next day it won't be there. Most of the perception is like that. We need to change the perception. We need to be standing stiff out there. Yes, we are there and we'll be there for you. We don't need to move out from that place. So I think reliability is another big factor, so that we, most of the regional market is like that. Like, it's not very focused. It's not in a single manner. So we need to put up more like that.
Dipankar, any last word from agency side in terms of how to build reliability or how to really bring that language, creative, and that combination done?
One thing that comes to my mind is that this being so fragmented, the ownership being so fragmented, because of which the learning of a metro doesn't go down so much below in the lower down the pop strata. So if there are media owners who are in the metros and they are expanding and they are putting that kind of money in those kind of towns, I think a lot of learning will flow on, because there's a huge disconnect between the media owners there and the media owners in the metro. So that learning is somewhere not flowing in.
Okay, so we've got a few minutes there. Any question to the panel at the moment? Suresh, any question to the panel?
This is for everyone. I mean, more of the metric side. So this debate about having the right metric in OH has not settled. What is the next phase? I mean, where do we see that equation coming to on the metric side? I mean, how would you say a couple of years down the line, I mean, where would we be? Any one of you?
Who wants to take that?
Shall I make an attempt?
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, we have always spoken about metrics and measurement across all conferences that I've personally been part to, and all the discussions that we ever get into this. But I like we discussed a little while back, you know, we are actually, some of us are waiting for a third party, an outsider, or maybe somebody from inside who create an independent, you know, measurement system, like the way we have DAM, BARC, ABC, IRS, all of those. So something, you know, an independent unit has to be created, an independent body, and that should start getting into measurement of sites and metrics. I think that is something that will possibly solve the problem, but I don't know what we are possibly waiting for.
So we thought we'll not discuss on measurement, because that itself is a big topic. So thank you for bringing that up. Any other question?
Yeah. Okay. This is generally for the panel and for the anchor. Pardon if I sound a little outdated, having moved from the industry to the academics. I find the platforms that we are discussing for outdoor or OH was, let's say, airports, railway stations, maybe bus shelters. I want to know the relevance of a couple of things that we have done in the industry. Like in the World Cup, we had taken a car out, you know, for the during the drinks break and all that. I have even, what about the balloon part? Now, we had tried that, putting up in the Haji Ali during a launch. We found that was very impactful. And it sort of validates what the previous speaker had said about the visual impact. What about boards behind autos and buses? I have found that very useful. What about stepney covers and scooters? They are very informative and very relevant. What about putting stickers in the cars? Using radio taxis as a source of your information. Are these relevant today, or wall paintings are rural marketing areas or the rural areas? You know, painting boats in the rivers, it could be Varanasi, Calcutta and all that. Are these relevant today, or do you tend to use it in your marketing and branding?
Sunit, can you answer this? Because your Northeast is like, you know, microcosm of all the states. And
see, I get your question very well. I think, you know, some of these are relevant today. Most of these are relevant today, except for the scooter tire, stepney branding, because nowadays there are no scooters.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Population has decreased.
Exactly. So we have moved to scooter rates now. And I think others are still relevant today for local or regional players. Yeah. We do not see large national brands advertising through these mediums. Because one is lack of awareness. Second is, you know, they do not want to get into the hassles of the execution, what will happen, kya hoga, nahi hoga, pata nahi hai. And nobody wants to take a chance, basically.
I think execution quality is a question mark in most of the things.
Hygiene issue is there. Yeah. So that's why these are not being used.
And permission is also another issue. Like, you don't.
So local brands are engaging with these mediums still.
Yeah, that's how it should be. And because it was regional markets, I thought it should have that. Like your Pujo example was a very good example for that matter.
Thank you.
Any other question? Thank you so much. Thanks all the panelists for your time and discussions.
I request you to please stay on stage. I thank all the panel members for this interesting session, and I request you to please stay back. I now invite Mr. Atul Srivastava, Executive Director and CEO, Lakshya Media Group, to please come on stage and give the token of appreciation to all our lovely panelists. And let's have a huge round of applause, everybody. I'm sure we agree that it was very insightful, and I think it's going to get even more interesting as the day progresses. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen.